We popped up a little while ago and we had a technical challenge. So I thought I'll pop back and see how you're doing now. So there we are. So welcome, welcome back. I say the time is just gone at 10 o'clock. Yes, indeed. 2 minutes past 10 on Thursday evening. So there we are. Wonderful to have you with us, of course, and lots of good quality chat. So there you go. So come and join us. Let us know if you can see and hear me. It's always the little technical things. What we're trying to do here is build up a massive internet phone-in, same as we do on radio. So there we are, massive internet phone-in now. Obviously, over the last 3 nights, we've been trying to get the technical side of it right, and we've managed pretty well up until now, I say. And, of course, tonight we just had a little problem with the calls. So if you're able to call in, that would be absolutely incredible. Do feel free to do so. And I'll give you the number. Can you see this here? SCOTTIE McCLUE YouTube phone-in. Call now, 0141628. There we are. Fantastic. 9795. And it's along the bottom of the screen as well, of course. You're live on Scotty's phone in. Who's that?
Hello, Scotty.
Yes, who's that?
It's Dave the Brave.
Dave, how lovely to hear from you.
It is lovely. Honestly, on radio, there are three people. There's you, Art Bell, Pete Price. I spoke to another one. I've spoken to you now. Unfortunately, I haven't spoken to Art Bell because he passed away, but lovely to talk to you, Scott.
Just amazing. This is absolutely incredible. And Dave, thank you for all your support.
No problem. You mentioned something in your last stream about the stuff in Afghanistan going on.
Yes, yes. I mean, obviously, it's pretty shocking stuff. And with the explosions today and that kind of carry on, we wonder where these people's minds actually are, you know?
Very good point, but I think it's a bloody lost cause, if you ask me, because you've been there, I don't know, I've been listening here for, I don't know, 20 years, plus 20 plus years, we've deployed the world's best troops,
yes.
i.e. us, the Americans, the Scottish are the best, the Scottish are the best, and still no resolution, so I don't know where we're going to go with this.
Yeah, you wonder just how much people want a resolution. I mean, there's something underlying there. All the superpowers have had a good look at it. It's like people used to say Africa's such a poor country. Africa's one of the richest places in the world in terms of resources. But
well, it used to be. I remember, like, Rhodesia used to be, like, the richest, Rhodesia.
Well, Rhodesia, now Zimbabwe, of course, was the breadbasket of Africa. And then, since independence, all that's been ruined.
It has. The thing is, it's different religions, different cultures, different way of living. So I don't know. It's different way of living to us. So I don't think there's a resolution. I think there's just... We can't exactly put like a democratic parliament or jury because it's not going to work, is it?
No, I don't think that's wanted under certain regimes, obviously, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Very, very good. Oh, Scotty, it's been very good talking to you. I'll let you get on with the next
Dave,
call.
Dave, lovely to hear from you. And thank you very much. As I say, apologies for the technical difficulties at the start.
Not a problem. Hearing it all clear well. Carry on, you're doing well, and I'm listening on YouTube. Carry on, mate.
Bless you, dinky do, mate, and all the very best.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Dave. Thank you very much. There we are. What a top man. Fantastic. Right, we seem to be back in business, guys. I do apologize for the technical challenges at the start this evening. But we'll take your calls, see how we get on. Sensible people, please, no trolls. You're live in Scotty's phone in.
See how we get on.
Hello.
Scotty.
Hello.
Hello there, sir. It's Eddie Boy, Scotty.
Eddie Boy, how are you?
I am good, I'm good.
This is...
I'm talking to a celebrity.
I'm talking to a celebrity. This is marvellous. And, of course, you're in Newmarket.
Yes, I'm in Newmarket, Scotty, yes. I used to be in a wee beautiful place in the country called Maryhill.
Maryhill, I know it so well, of course. Lived a good bit of my life there.
Aye. So how's it going? going your end, Scotty?
It's great, Eddie. And listen, thank you, as I say, for all the marvellous support over the years, because it's great to see you. And you've been with me on Facebook and
TikTok
and everywhere, you know.
Right, Scotty, can I have a wee question for you?
Yes.
Right, what do you think of all this carry-on with Afghanistan?
Well, I think it's absolutely crazy. I mean, it really, really is, you know. I don't understand where people are coming from, but then you see, we don't have the same mindset, you know. That's the thing. So it's getting into that mindset, and I'm not sure that a Westerner can easily get into an Eastern mindset.
Aye, I get what you mean, Scotty. But Scotty, now, you're a man of the faith, and so am I, my friend, right?
Yes.
Do you believe we're living in the end times?
Well, it's it's very, very interesting that you should come up with that. You know, do we believe we're living in the end times? I think it's all in the good book.
Oh, aye.
You know?
Oh, yes, definitely.
I think it's actually all in the good book. And I think if people read the good book, they'll see what's going on. And the people of violence at the moment are not genuinely religious people. They are twisting and bending their religion.
Aye. Well, I think we're living in... As I say, the end of the end times.
Mm-hmm.
I think the world's going to pot, Scotty. I mean, like, you get your conspiracy theorists also, right?
Yes.
Today with this COVID vaccine, right? They think, mm-hmm. Some people think that you're being injected with a chip, like a tracking device.
Ah!
People think
all these things.
It's going to alter your DNA and different things, but...
I'll be honest with you. See, if you go down these roads, though, you'll turn yourself absolutely inside out. You know what I mean?
Aye, I agree with you there, Scotty. Aye, I do agree with you there, man. Aye. But, Scotty, one more question before I go, right? I remember there was a wee mention for you about Ocean Radio.
Oh, yes, Ocean Radio.
Is the station you're going to be hooked up to, or what?
Yeah, well, no, Ocean Radio, we didn't go forward with that. I would imagine it's the pandemic. I didn't want to put anybody on the spot, but I would. If you think about it, the tourists are not flying there.
Right, I see.
Do you see what I mean? So it you know, it's sensible not to be starting too big a setup for people, I would have said. I don't know. It's not my setup. I was just very kindly invited to be a part of it. But then the pandemic hit.
Yeah.
You see?
Well, you're the first lot on the internet, Scotty, and you were I was nearly about to see the F word there, Scotty.
Oh no, don't for goodness sake.
Legend on Scott FM.
Oh my goodness me. No, well, you see, Scott FM, now if you think about it, Scott FM was not on the internet. If that had been on the internet, we would have been right round the world.
Aye.
You see?
But listen, Scotty, I really do wish you all the best and all success with the radio, getting on the radio waves and having the live phone-ins. Because, Scotty, it was brilliant years ago, man.
Yes.
It was really good banter, and you were a good laugh, Scotty.
We got the banter going and what have you. And your problem with a lot of mainstream stations is that the managers are risk-averse. You see, and they worry needlessly. I mean, I've had one complaint upheld in just under 30 years.
Just under 30 stretch? Wow, Scotty.
30 years, and you know some of the stuff I've come out with in my time.
Yes, I do, Scotty, yeah.
You see? So, I mean, at the end of the day, but I think what we're doing right now, Eddie, it just needs to be publicised. But what we are doing right now is, I think, the future.
Oh, I definitely. And listen, Scotty, I'm just going to say something, because I know there's a lot of listeners out there. Scotty McCluve for MP.
Scotty McCluve for an MP.
Definitely, man.
I'll go and be an MP for you.
Scotty, I don't see say that jokingly. I say that seriously.
No, well, that's very, very kind of you. Yes, I might consider that.
Definitely.
You know.
Well, Scotty, it's been a pleasure. I can't believe I'm speaking to you. I wanted to hear your voice on the other end of a phone call for years.
Well, this is a joy for me, Eddie, and lovely to hear from you. And all the best to Newmarket.
Yes, all the best in horse racing.
Yes, and dinky do.
And dinky do to you the new.
Top man the new. There he goes. How amazing is that? That is fantastic. Now, where is our chat? I need the chat. I need to hear what you guys are up to. Where is the chat? The chat's usually here. Here it is. Good. Excellent stuff. Now, here we've got everybody in here. Love your videos, says Aaron, 3 minutes past 10. So this is up to date. I thank you. Oi, oi, back again. Good stuff. David, thank you. At 8 minutes past 10. Gordon Robertson, an absolute top man. Hello, sound and vision, both good. Scotty the legend, says Lizzie. I think, yes, absolutely. Scotty is an MP. I'd vote for him, says Bob. Very, very kind of you, Bob. Thank you for that. Dinky-doo. If you've just joined us then, a very, very warm welcome. You're watching Scottie McCLUE, hashtag FLOTI, the first lord of the internet, all in uppercase. Let's try and get that trending, for heaven's sake, because what you'll find is Scotty's taking the long route back. So there we go. So this will obviously need a bit of publicizing. If everybody can tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10, that would be very much appreciated. We're slowly but surely getting the technical side of things right. We had a problem with the phones tonight, things like that. You can have that anywhere on any station. So there you go. So we tiny Scotty McCLUE just beavering away here with these little bits of crystal set. You know, here's what we're getting. Here's the result. All right. I know I'm no oil painting, but there we are. Dinky-doo, Scotty. How are you? J-Dog, how lovely to have you with us. Are we clear tonight on YouTube, Skype, and Facebook? I ask you. I can actually see the Facebook Live here, so that's rather good. I'm going to love my own post. And somebody once said to me, why do you love your own post? No, why do you like your own post? This was yonks ago on one of the social media platforms. And I said, because there's not a love button. Sure enough, not long after that, a love button was introduced on that platform. I'm not kidding. And it's great fun. And if you like your stuff, you get everybody absolutely up in arms doing the not. Well, did you just like your own thing? You don't do that. And you say, no, it's a test to see if somebody's got nothing else to talk about, and they'll talk about your like. Do you see what I mean? Fantastic. Scotty, I see you're using, yes, how many platforms you're on? Gordon, I'm on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch with a bit of luck. Yes, but it is luck. We don't actually know. And I was on TikTok, but they did their nut because I put the phone number up and they thought it was my own phone number. But I've just sent in the little appeal to say, no. It's a public phone number for people to phone in for a wee chat. So you're very welcome, Gordon. I have my new mug for you already for the latest. Yes, I chose Restream Gordon because they seemed to be the best at what they do. I saw your amazing call with Alex Belfield. Oh, J-Dog. I had to just stick to my guns with Alex. Alex is a big YouTube star. But I thought, no, he's not getting away with slagging off Scotland as Nicky Nacky Newland and all that stuff. I thought that has to stop. So there we are. So that was it. So I hope you liked that one, J-Dog. The man had to be told, I say. So I'm not running TikTok tonight at the moment because we've enough going on with the three platforms. If you want to follow Scotty McCLUE on Twitch, it's Scotty_McCLUE. The YouTube channel is youtube.com/user/ScottyMcClue1. Yes, indeed. And Facebook, of course, you just go in and get Scottie McCLUE's Facebook. That's no problem at all. If you've just joined us, as I say, a very, very warm welcome. You'll see that we are a phone-in and that Scottie McCLUE is a talk show host. It's great, isn't it? All that, very loose. Are you looking at the chat through the Restream chat? I am, yes, but I think there's also some chat on here on Facebook, so we can get that. There we are. Good to see you back, Scottie. This is the wonderful Gordon Roddick. Thank you, Gordon, and thank you for your terrific generosity in GoFundMe.com/Scottie-McCLUE. So there we are. All right. Now, what have we got here? Good evening, Scottie. Hope you're fine and well. Sounds great on Facebook tonight, Mr. C. So there we are, says David Lafferty. And wonderful. Everybody's watching us on all these different platforms. We shall build it up a little bit at a time. If you'd like to call me, do so. So there we are. Fantastic. Now, I've got the chat here. Yes, I am, J-Dog. That's exactly what I'm doing. So I'm not looking at the YouTube chat at the moment, but we can do. It's wonderful. And thank you very, very much indeed. Somebody's been suggesting tonight that I become an MP, a Mike Papa. What do we think about that? Mike Papa, radio chat there, you see. This is, what would I say? What would Scottie be? So there we go. I would need to work it all out and get it going for you in the radio alphabet. Marvelous stuff, marvelous. Right, now everything coming in loud and clear. J-Dog, if you can do a quick round robin for me, I would be, as always, eternally grateful, just to see that everything's working well. Fantastic. Are the phones working? Does somebody want to give us a call? We've got the number here. We're on YouTube and we're on Facebook and we're on Twitch and we may be going on LinkedIn as well. Scottie McCLUE YouTube phone in. Call Scottie now, 0141-628-9765. Do you see it along the bottom of the screen as well, guys? You should be able to see it there. Scottie McCLUE, hashtag FLOTI. And then you've got call, 0141-628-9795. Wonderful. Does that phone number actually get to me? Yes, it does, Gordon. It gets straight to me. I'm amazed how you've managed to work out how to have your live streams recorded on Twitch. Oh, there we go. J-Dog, never be amazed at anything Scottie McCLUE does because it's very likely by accident. So I've clicked something that I was meant to click without realizing it. All right, so I'm just tipping you the wink. There are many, many things that I would consider myself to be fairly good at. But you'll find that some of the greatest moments in my life and in my career have happened by accident. There we go. Dinky-doo. Karmic's watching us. You're very welcome. Lovely to have you with us. Fantastic stuff. Just saying dinky-doo to everybody there. And we're just a tiny bit of a lag. That's it. You're getting a wave now on Facebook. This is what it's all about. Hello, says Gordon. Hello, Gordon. Are you just testing out the chat? Hello to you. So I shall say back, hello, Gordon. Let's see if this works. That's hello. It's actually hello. And you've got to watch because Gordon is a sort of grammarian. There we go. Wonderful. What have I got here? That's it. Right. There we are. Hello, Gordon and wee Oliver. That'll let you know that it's for you, won't it? So there we are. So that should be coming up now, and you should get that. Hello, Gordon and wee Oliver. So let me know if you've got that, Gordon. That's fantastic. We're doing a lot of technical testing tonight. If anybody wants to try out the phones, feel free to do so. We popped up earlier, and we did have a challenge with the phones, but feel free to try it out now. It's just not a problem, I can tell you. There we go. Thank you. Did you get that one, Gordon? Good. Well, it lets you know it's live because you might be saying, I don't trust McCLUE. He's all over the internet. I don't know if this is live or not. You know, that's the sort of idea. Now, what kind of phone-in would you like? Would you like it subject-based, topic-based? When would you like it to start officially? What time would you like to have your phone in at? Because remember, this is your show. I've done these shows now for coming up 30 years. And I love doing them because it's real people with real chat. So not a problem. I would like to make them as cheerful as possible because the world is in such a shambles. And I think I blame a lack of leadership. I don't blame any leaders. I blame a lack of leadership. And I'm beginning to think that the media getting rid of the Donald was not actually as smart a move as they thought it was. And I'm beginning to think that maybe Uncle Joe isn't quite doing what we thought he might do. All right. Can we have prayers and community singing? Of course we can, Gordon. Shall we gather at the river? All of us sleeping at the other end of the couch. I like the late night phone-ins. Ah, yes. Has Oliver gone away? Do you think he's thought, no, I haven't enough of this? He's not up for it. Do your neighbors recognize us, Scottie McCLUE? Yes, everybody knows Scottie McCLUE. My goodness me. I'll tell you a lovely thing. I called into a fast food joint quite recently, and I got it a bit wrong. I should have stopped at a machine and given my order, and I'd passed it by, and there was a big queue behind me. Anyway, they were very, very kind about it, and I just fessed up right away. I said, look, here's what, and they went, yes, we know what you've done. It's not a problem, sir. So there we go. And I said, well, if I can pay, and they said, yes, if you pay, and if you go and park up, we'll bring it to you. Anyway, I'm sitting, and a young gentleman came out from the fast food joint, and he really made my day, because he said, there you are, sir, handed me my order. And I said, thank you very much, and paid him. And he said, by the way, I love what you're doing. So there you go. Now, I thought, he said, I love your radio thing. There you are. Now, there we are. McClune. Do you remember Mad John from Knightswood? Yes, I do, Suzanne. Do you know Mad John from Knightswood? There we go. We liked Mad John. Is anybody calling tonight? Are the phones working? Let me test it. Where's the phone? Oh, I can't. It's doing something at the moment. So there we are. If somebody wants to test it out, if you don't want to talk, ring the number and hang up. 01416289795. Ring the number and hang up. I do, Suzanne. Yes, I remember. I remember Mad John used to come on, McClune. He would shout and bawl at us. Then he would say, see you in 6 months. He was obviously on his way back to the slammer. That's what it was all about. These calls were quite out of this world. Another of my great favorites was the youngsters calling themselves the Viking. The Viking. Yes, I'll run you through, McClune. Oh, here we go. The phones are working. You're live on Scotty's phone in. Who's that? Hello? We didn't hear much of you, but we know you were there. It was a treat to hear you. If you want to ring again, we shall try it. But at least we know the phones are working. The old rugged cross on the squeeze box. Eddie, I'll have to do a bit of work with that one. I do have the squeeze box, though. Here it is here. And if we'd like a wee tune, we could probably manage one. What about this one? I know you like this one. Bye. go, guys. Did you like that one? A Ouija of the squeeze box for you. Wonderful stuff. Wonderful, says Eddie Doyle. Eddie Doyle, so lovely to hear you tonight in the flesh, as they say. And I'm so glad everything's working loud and clear at last. I was maybe getting distracted by running an extraneous stream on the TikTok. Wonderful stuff. Always love the box. The box is very nice, Gordon. And I know you're a very fine musician yourself. And I believe a very fine singer. Am I correct? Are you too young to remember the great Glasgow Orpheus Choir? I actually met members of that. And I had a dear friend who's just died not long ago. And it was touch and go who was the finer voice, this lady or Kathleen Ferrier. A wonderful lady called Norma Proctor. And she knew Kathleen Ferrier very, very well. And they had the same teacher. Yes, a gentleman that they knew as Prof, a wonderful baritone singer that brought out these two wonderful voices. And Norma, as a little one, was pictured with Sir Hugh Robertson of the Orpheus Choir. Here is Belmont. Here is Orling. Tremendous stuff. I liked your TikTok video. You're very good at it. Splendid rendition. You're getting the hang of it. Gordon Stilling, how lovely of you to join us. Now, I'm so glad you've joined us because we'd lost track of you. And I think that you made a wee error of judgment one night. But I don't think you'll ever do that again. So I'm very glad you're back with us. Well done, Gordon. Good to have you back with us, Frey. Is it Frey the Pans or Frey the Mary? Fantastic. Out in East Lothian. Let Glasgow flourish by the preaching of his word. Eddie Doyle, St. Mungo. There we go. Do you know, I think somebody was telling me that they preferred when Christ of St. John on the Cross, bought by Dr. Tom Honeyman in 1958, I think it was, for 8,000 quid, and everybody did their nut. It used to hang in the St. Mungo Museum. Now it's back in the refurbished Kelvin Grove Art Galleries, and it's in a corner, and there's glass on it. Aha. Only 4 months to Christmas, Scotty. I can't believe it. Good evening, by the way, from you-know-where. Lee, how lovely to have you with us. Is that Lee in Barnsley? Barnsley, love. Yes, fantastic. We love it. Spread the word, guys. Get the word out there. All right. And remember, my teeth are still white. They just look a bit yellow because the background's yellow. It's reflecting. Is the phone in working? Apparently so, Dwayne. So feel free to give us a wee call if you would like so to do. You'd be very welcome. Nobody would mind that at all. Why is this not on TikTok, says Dwayne? Well, we did try TikTok with us tonight, but TikTok's extraneous, so I can't simultaneously live stream to TikTok. So there we are. But we will shall see. We might go back on TikTok for you if the TikTokers would like that. Tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10. Yes, indeed. We need to spread the word, guys. We're only a few nights old. Most of that's been teething troubles. Not me personally. As I say, my teeth are fine. The dentist said they were absolutely lovely, but he did say my gums might have to come out. However, there we go. Yes, you can. So liked and shared. Dinky-doo. Lovely to have you with us. Thank you very much. Craig, get liking, get sharing, everybody. Tell 10 to tell 10. Don't be shy. And if you're watching on YouTube, please get subscribing. We must build these subscribers up. I think the YouTube channel, I haven't used it much apart from as a repository for 1,600 SCOTTIE McCLUE videos for your education, edification, enjoyment, and delight. So make sure you avail yourself of these videos. They are there for you. They've been made with love for you to enjoy. There's one or two cheeky ones, people phoning me in the old phone-in days and cheeking up to McCLUE. Tut, tut, tutity, tut, I say. So that's what was going on there. So you can get a bit of that. Fantastic stuff. We like it. Right, somebody's calling. You're live on Scotty's Phone In. Who is that?
Dinky-doo, it's Shakaroni.
Shakaroni, how lovely to have you with us.
How lovely to be here. Yes, I tried earlier tonight, but I know you've had some technical difficulties. Sometimes, but at least you're back on.
One or two little technical difficulties, Shakarani, but that doesn't mean we don't love you.
Yeah, well, you can't be stopped.
No, we mustn't.
Big one, and now YouTube tonight, when that's gone down a bit.
Yeah, that's gone down, so we sorted that. So hopefully everything's working fine now.
I just wanted to let you know, Scotty, the site you're using to broadcast Restream,
yes,
they've said that they're going to put a way for you to broadcast to TikTok through their app soon. They're working on it. So
wow.
Hopefully in a few months, you should be able to put your number and the YouTube feed from your site, from how you're hosting it, over to the TikTok mobile.
Wow. Incredible, isn't it?
That'd be cool.
Yeah, that would be so cool. It really would. That would be mega cool, because I'll tell you, I love TikTok, and we've only been on it for, what now, maybe 12 weeks.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think we've got about 17,000 followers. And 40,000 likes.
Well, we're doing brilliant on TikTok. It's a big one. You've got so many followers over there, and they just kind of popped up. And
yeah,
ever since, you've got people who didn't catch you on the radio and been catching up like me. You've got, you know, people who do know you. You've got everyone and everything going on over on TikTok.
Yes, and they were doing their nut. They were absolutely doing their nut, because I'd put the phone number in. And I've just appealed it, because obviously they think I've given out my own phone number when it's, you know.
But I think if they look at it,
they'll think, oh, no, that's absolutely fine.
I see what the issue could have been, but I suppose as long as you explain that it's a calling number and it's all sorted.
Well, there wasn't actually a facility to explain. You just appeal it, say disagree, you know.
I see what you mean now.
Just, now, do you see what I've got with me tonight as a new addition?
What have you got, sorry?
Can you see the screen at the moment?
I can't at the moment, because when I call, I can't do YouTube and the phone at the same time. But when I've been watching, I've been able to see the phone number on the screen.
I have a lovely new mug with the boss on it.
Well, that's what you are. You are the boss.
See? McClure's the boss.
You've been a boss of many radio stations, and you know, and now you're the boss of your own phone and Scotty's phone. And
I love the old joke when the guy says to the wee guy, says, right, let's sort this out, you and me. He says, I am the boss, you are nobody. And the guy goes, okay, so I am nobody. He said, you are nobody. He says, so you are the boss of nobody.
That's a good one.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Did you hear the joke about the three holes in the ground?
No.
Well.
Do you think I should go live on TikTok just now, or do you think that's holding...
Well, I think your closet accordion fan might be waiting for you on there, Stevie.
He
tends to jump out when you're on TikTok, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Will we go live on TikTok?
Well, if I could put my hand up, I would say, yes, please.
Dinky-do to you. Lovely to hear from you.
Take care.
Take care. All the very best, la.
And a big dinky-do.
And a big dinky-do to you. There we are. Our Shakarani. What a top man. That is excellent stuff. I'm just wondering if I should go back live on TikTok and just see what's happening there, because it's a massive, massive platform for Scotty McClure. I'll just call it Dinky Doo, and I'll pop that up. There's about 3,000 people waiting for me there right now, Dinky Doo, so it's marvellous. Just let me welcome our TikTokers. Welcome, 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 TikTokers. Lovely to have you with us, and so glad you could make it. There we go. Scotty McClure popping up just to say hi to every single one of you. Here we go. And wonderful Dinky Doo back up and running. We are indeed. Who have I got here? You're live on Scotty's phone in. Who's that?
Hello, Scotty. It's Archie.
Here. Archie, you did indeed. Archie from the Borders.
From Jedburgh, yeah.
Jedburgh and the Borders.
I was thinking if there's anything else I could talk to you about with Jedburgh. Jedbra, and I remember something.
Yes.
So, you know, obviously, Robert the Bruce, how he had a cave in Arran.
Yes.
Winning.
Yes.
Well, there's an old rumour that there's a bridge on the outskirts of, just out of the A68, that up there, Robert the Bruce actually had another cave. It's very hard. It may not be true, but I find
he had a what? Had a kid?
Had a cave.
Oh, a cave. I thought he'd married one of the locals.
I've no idea if it's true or not.
In a cave. Well, it may well be. Bruce was a very prolific character.
He absolutely now, was. And he was inspired by the spider with the web in the cave.
Yes.
The Arran cave.
And you'll have seen my video of that this week. I came out in the morning and a spider, the genius that it is, had actually done that.
Oh, really?
You know, and I thought that was absolutely incredible. It just woven this wonderful web. And I thought, I have to get this, at the expense of being a few minutes late, I have to get this up on TikTok.
Yeah.
You know, absolutely amazing. Now, Robert the Bruce, I was just going to tell you, Melrose was one of his stamping grounds, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Yes. And but his heart went
his
to...
His heart is buried at the Abbey.
At Melrose?
Yes.
And then the rest of them went to Dunfermline or Arbroath.
Okay, I'd never heard that part, but okay.
I think, yes, where the rest of... But anyway, his heart. Now, also, I'm sure there was a box. This is, I mean, I'm just plucking stuff out the air here. I'm sure there was a box at Mount Stuart House that had held Bruce's heart.
Oh, wow.
Yes. I seem to remember something like that. So there's another bit for you. And Tarbert in Argyll, not Tarbet and not Tarbert Harris, but Tarbert in, and not Tarbert in Ireland, Tarbert in Argyll, at the top of the isthmus between West and East Loch Tarbert. And Bruce was on the run there. In Tarbert, you've got Tarbert Castle, and you've got Bruce Hill. So he was very, very prolific around Argyll and mid-Argyll. And he was on the run, and he nearly starved to death. And a lady goat came along and let him suckle her milk. That allowed him to remain alive.
Wow.
And what he did after that, he decreed when he became king that all goats should have right of free passage in Scotland. So you'll see wild goats wandering about in Scotland.
Wow. Oh, that's excellent. I never knew that.
There's a wee bit of chat for you. And, of course, the other great man from the borders, from where well, there's been so many, Walter Scott, of course, and yourself.
Oh, yes.
The other great thing was, what was I going to tell you about from the borders? I was going to tell you an amazing story from the borders there. Oh, yes. Yes, from Hawick.
Oh, right, okay.
Yes, Bill McLaren, the rugby commentator.
Oh, Bill McLaren.
What a lovely man. And I have one regret. I have very, very few regrets in my broadcasting career, but I have one regret. I came off air one day in Scott FM, and here was this gentleman sitting dressed in the finest Borders knitwear and the finest leather shoes. And I said to my producer, "That's Bill McLaren." She went, "Bill, yes, of course, aye. And we ain't have a chat with him. He'd love to chat to you." And then she added affectionately, she said, "But if you were rushing for your lunch, it might be quite a long chat because Bill does like to chat."
He did.
And I was about to, I thought, I'll nip for my lunch and grab him when I come back. I was only going for a roll, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm off out the door, down to the baker's, back with a roll. I said, where's Bill? And they said, "Oh, he had to go, Scott, he's away."
Oh.
And I never got to talk to the great man.
Oh, that's a shame. There's a statue of Bill in Hoyk at Wilton. There's a statue of him there, along with Steve Hisbop, the biker that died in a helicopter crash.
Yes.
It's quite a good statue, enough. It's in a nice place too.
Well, Bill always said that a day out of Hoyt was a day wasted.
Yes.
Listen, lovely to talk, Archie. I'm going to move on, and we will catch up soon.
Dinky
do, all the very best. You want a top man? There we are. Archie from the Scottish Borders, from Jedburgh, which is a stunning, stunning wee toon with a beautiful abbey that was ruined. I think we should have it rebuilt now. Lots of people on TikTok going daft here, wondering what's going on here. Dinky doodle, thanks, Kevrich. He never responds to the same comment. Kevrich, I do. I'm just very busy. There we are. Who else have we got? Fantastic. Hello, Sir McClure. Big shout out from Drum Chapel. Thank you, Scott. Back to the telephones. You're live on Scotty's Phone In. Who's that?
Hello, it's Wonky.
Wonky, how lovely to hear from you. Can you believe we've been back up for 42 minutes?
And exactly, yes. I have been meaning to call in, but I seen the lines weren't working. Unknown gave me the hat tip, the lines were down, so I waited till they were fixed and I jumped straight on. Straight on.
And everything should be working fine now, Wonky.
Oh, it is working perfectly now. I've got.
Have you checked out all the feeds?
All the feeds? I've only checked out YouTube and. No, it was only YouTube. I was going to do Twitch, but realised I already had YouTube open. So.
Two seconds. Your gums have to come out. I've never heard that one, Scotty. Thoughts and prayers to our brothers and sisters in Kabul. Absolutely. Radio show, entertain and education is your forte and always has been. Start at 10 o'clock sharp. Scotty McCluey, the voice of the nation. Hey, Scotty, how's your business? How are your people? There are bits of his heart placed at St. Serf's. In Leavengrove Park in Dumbarton, Scotty. Mark my words, that is brilliant to hear. I thank you. Now, sorry about that, Wonky, but we did have to have a wee catch-up because we're doing a lot of things here.
No, that's quite all right. Right, so I have a request and a question.
Aha.
Okay, so my question is, lots of commenters on TikTok, I'm sure, we'll get in on this, and YouTube, and Twitch, and Facebook, hopefully. So, we've got a full English breakfast, yes?
Yes.
Now, how is it full, and why would it be called full, when nobody I know eats the black pudding?
Well, everybody I know eats the black pudding, and I've eaten the black pudding myself on many an occasion.
Are you sure, Scotty? And there's not a group of you all pretending to like black pudding just so it stays on the.
Yeah, but hold on. Is a full English breakfast, does it contain black pudding?
Well,
I think that's maybe more a Scottish thing.
Ah, no, because when I go to a certain cheap, greasy spoon restaurant. In England anyway, that's what it comes with, you see. So that's what I thought I'd ask you. So it makes me think, well, for the sake of this topic then, because you're Scottish, we'll call it a full breakfast. But
well, there's a full Scottish breakfast, you see, and that can include haggis.
I'm on about the English.
Well, there's a full Geordie breakfast in Newcastle, and that includes haggis, I think.
Okay, no, I've not tried the haggis one, so I can't say anything on that front. But black pudding, yes. So does it deserve to be classed on the full breakfast when nobody eats it? Can't we just have one less and put something else in its place? Because I don't know anyone who eats it and nobody likes it.
Well, I don't know how you can't not like black pudding. What about white pudding?
Oh, no, I'm not going to try that if I don't like black pudding, am I?
Well, no, white pudding's oatmeal, you see. Black pudding's blood pudding.
No, I'm staying out of it.
Now, you get into that, and I'll tell you another thing you could try, Wonky, is fruit pudding.
Fruit pudding?
Yes. Although I'm not mad on fruit pudding for two reasons. One, it goes a bit mushy in the pan, and the other is...
TikTok, Scotty, see, everyone's saying now that black pudding is, that nobody eats it, nobody likes it. Everyone's in agreement with me.
That's not true.
Oh, check TikTok.
I'll check. Wait, do we see? Who have we got here? Yes, the black pudding is meaningless. Black pudding is bra, says Mark.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for 20 beautiful shamrocks from Darren. What have we got here? I've eaten the black pudding in the vain hope it would propel me towards a Scottish noble title. That's coming from the United States, from Aggie. He doesn't like black pudding, doon the Swanee he goes. There you go. So you could head off down the Swanee. Get this guy off. This was his subject, and he knows so little.
Well, if you want to get me off, you call in and challenge Scotty and try and get him to get me off. But we follow each other on Twitter. We're a good friend, me and Scotty, so I don't think you'll be getting me down with 20 anytime soon.
Yeah, they're all doing the nut. You can't beat a bit of black pudding. You need black pudding. It's a must in Scotland.
No, you don't. No, yes. You don't.
Everybody needs the black pudding.
No. I mean, lots of people on YouTube are enjoying it. They're saying, yes, they think they need it, but lots of TikTok are saying otherwise.
Right, I'm going to read the comments, and I'll catch up with you soon, Wonky.
Okay, you know, but before you go...
Dinky-doo.
My question... Yes,
go on.
...is can we have a bit of a squeeze box in case Steve is listening?
Well, we've just had it.
No, but a bit more.
A bit more squeeze box?
Yes.
Some more? Mr. Bumble.
And a general sup.
A general sup. I think we'll have a general sup of from the boss.
Okay.
There we go. I'm just telling the TikTokers what's going on here. Absolutely. Thank you. Some more. Ta-la-la. Right, he's gone. My goodness me. What are we going to do? Black pudding is the bullseye on the breakfast board, says Mark. But what's black pudding every time, says Mark? There we are. Make them try a McCLUE tea dumpling. I see what you just did there. Very clever. McCLUE tea dumpling. Think you do. Fantastic. Lovely to have you all with us and a very warm welcome. If you've just joined us here on TikTok, this is the big one. We are multi-streaming. We're on YouTube. We're on Twitch. We're on Facebook Live. What is black pudding, folks, is sabotage. Are you from the United States of America? Sabotage, because you might not have heard of it. How's the time doing? Oh my goodness, we've got 10 minutes and then we have to go to bed. Apparently, they're wonderful. What have we got here? Yes, you can. Thank you very much. Now, we've got lots of good stuff here. I never knew about bits of Bruce's heart being in Dumbarton, and I have walked that park many a time, very close to the old Kewl School in Dumbarton. I don't know if we've got any Kewl School FPs with us. So to the Waverley today, past the lovely site, Albert Road and Ashton, and headed to the Gantocks. John Young, you're some man, I'll tell you. The Waverley, she's beautiful. I'm hearing great things and she's looking great. Somebody said they might be extending the season. Is that right? Have I got that correct? Here's Tom in Barnsley. Hey, dinky-doo. Lovely to have you with us, Tom, and a very warm welcome. If you've just joined us, folks, and you've seen us for the first time, then you're watching Scottie McCLUE, hashtag FLOTI, all uppercase, FLOTI, the first lord of the internet. And we are building up an international phone-in live online. All right, so be part of something very big. That's right, absolutely, me, Scotty, best back pudding. Is Stornoway black pudding. Yes, McPhee, from the bakers, from the butcher in the baker, the butcher in Stornoway. Stornoway. Yes, indeed. Absolutely. For the Yosocks. Off for my midnight curry. See you soon, everybody. Scott Fraser, dinky-doo, all the very best to you. Thanks for joining us live on TikTok. Welcome, welcome, I say. Now, who else have we got here? Hey. Anybody fancy a quick night-night phone call? And we'll leave it at that. Knight of the McCLUE table at your service. A Selkirk Bannock is hard to beat. John Young, we've just had a true borderer on there from Jedburgh, the Selkirk Bannock, the home of the Selkirk Bannock. Scotty, what's your perfect breakfast? I think probably a plate of porridge with honey and fresh cream. Darren, thank you for your beautiful gifts there. How amazing. Pandas. Darren is sending 36 pandas. 40, 50 pandas. Oh, my goodness. Scotty, how have you been? It's a while. So lovely to see you, my favorite man on TikTok. Dinky-doo. Clickstar. Welcome, welcome. We're live on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch right now as well. There we go. Thank you for 92 pandas, Darren. Who would be your ideal guest once you get the TV gig? You. Are we having a ruby then, Scotty? You should do Scotty Makes Breakfast stream. I might do. The only reason I'm not huge on television at the moment is because I don't cook. If I had a cookery program, that would be it. Scotty McCLUE. Scotty McClue's Saturday. There we are. Fantastic. All the trolls are scared to phone in. Hopefully, TikTok. Fantastic. Lovely to have everybody with us. Thanks for joining us, folks. Come and give us a phone call, of course. You'll see the number along the bottom of the screen. For our TikTokers, there it's there. The Scotty McCLUE YouTube phone-in. Call Scotty now. And please send us lots and lots of likes. Can everybody watching on TikTok follow me, please, and send the likes? There we are. Ha, Hannah, excellent. Yes, indeed. Who knows? I would be very privileged because that was marvelous seeing you all. Fantastic. Do come and join us, folks. Have we got that? There's Scotty McCLUE, YouTube phone-in. Call Scotty now. 01416289795. Prayers for Afghanistan, you know, and for the very, very deeply evil people that did the bombing. Deeply, deeply evil people. Good to see you on the old Twitch, Scotty. I hope you're well in the wee dug. Well, Angel, in actual fact, since you and I last spoke, the wee Doug passed away, but please don't panic. He was 14 and a half, just coming up 14 and a half. What a great wee guy. And behind me, you'll maybe be able to see Lord Reith. Let me see if I can get you having a look. There's Lord Reith behind me, guys. Can we see Lord Reith there? How amazing is that? That's him. Yes, what a beautiful dog. There we are. So thank you for that, Angel. So please, as I say, don't think anything of saying, because you want to know. I didn't publicize it. I told everybody when Lord Reith died 15 years ago. Fantastic. Hello there, Scotty McCLUE. Kevin Dodds, how lovely to have you with us. And a very big dinky-doo to you. Thank you. The only thing is, if we see Lord Reith, you see less of me, which is probably quite a good thing for you, I would think. There we are. Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining us. You're watching Scotty McCLUE, the first lord of the internet. Now, there we are. Last time I'm tuning in, if you don't start talking sense. Razboo, we've always talked sense. Don't ever not tune in to Scotty McCLUE. Brilliant. There we are. Fantastic. Lovely, lovely. And hi, Scotty. Hello, the real Shane. Good to have you with us. Yes, he's just thrown his toys out the pram, that guy. All of these people. Yes, welcome, welcome, I say. So good to have you. Hey, dinky-doo, dinky-doo, everybody. Fantastic. So my ideal guest, who would I have on first? I had David Heyman on the radio. He's outstanding. I would very much like to chat to David on the telly. So there we are. Do you like beans? Sad Hub, I have had beans in my day. I'm not mad. I like the green beans. I think that's a very good idea. If you've just joined us, welcome, welcome. P.S. Dodsy on TikTok. Ah, Dodsy, yes, we love you on TikTok. I've got the TikTokers here, and we are just chatting away. Raza Boombastic says, so let's talk about Kabul. Well, as you know, Raza Boombastic, Scotty McCLUE, can discuss anything, but I don't want to make the people sad before they go to their bed. And we've only got another couple of minutes. Have you ever been to Sandy Hills in the Stewartry? I was there yesterday. John Young, I know Sandy Hills in the Stewartry very, very well indeed. from my border television days. Yes, indeed. Do you know Pow Foot at all? There we go. Nearer to Annan. Some interesting stories there, I can tell you. Right, I think we're going to push off, guys. We'll leave it there for tonight. So sorry about the early technical problem at 9 o'clock, but we've sorted that. The number isn't working. Try it again, the boss. Yes, indeed, and we'll see if the number's working. Give it another shot. The number should definitely be working. Are you dialing the right one? It's 0141-628-9795. Scotty asked you this question on YouTube last night, but you've not seen it. Are you a ham radio operator? No, I don't spin it, but I've always admired the early hams talking to Australia and stuff like that. Fantastic. But no, it's not what I've done. But I did have a small crystal set that you flung the wire out the window and all that kind of stuff. The line is working fine. You are talking nonsense. You're live on Scotty's phone, and who's that? There you are, working fine. There we are. Maybe not able to speak when you get through, but working fine.
Hey, I'm Scotty. Sorry, it's me.
Oh, it is. Who's that?
It's Lee from Barnsley.
Lee from Barnsley. Hey, up, lad.
Hey, up, mate. How you doing?
I wish they.
I'm all right, mate. How are you?
I'm all right, mate. Hey, it's grand to hear thee.
God. Last time I spoke to you, what, over 20 years ago in
yeah.
a popular radio station in Sheffield.
Yeah, but Lee, what you've done, which is a lovely, lovely thing, you've stuck with me all the way.
Well, I followed you on YouTube for years, you know, since you first came on. One of my friends told me that you were on, and I've stuck with you through thick and thin, you know.
So you have done
it. It's just nice to see that you're still, you know, you're still going and you're still there on any kind of social media communication.
Well, you see, Lee, the whole thing is we haven't even scratched the surface yet. And, when I was on the radio, even when I was on Hallam FM, the technology wasn't quite there internet-wise.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, it's early stages then, weren't it?
It weren't as
prevalent as, you know, as it is now.
And even then, it was slow. It was dial-ins. It used up the bandwidth very, very quickly. You were trying to stuff all the information down a pipe. Because, you see, the internet, believe it or not, is actually old-fashioned technology compared with radio.
Well, I'm not, you know, I don't know enough about that to comment, really. But
no, but you see, just to put it...
I do remember the dial-up, though. That was
yes,
shocking.
When it went bloop, bloop, you know? Bloop, 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 bloop.
You know, as soon as someone actually picked the phone line up at other end to ring someone, that's it. It just cut out.
Well, when I was on Century Radio, a friend of mine who knew the internet said, Scotty, I'm going to put a page up tonight and mention the page on the station, and I'll tell you what happens. And then he said the reaction was absolutely breathtaking.
Well, yeah, I mean, through your radio broadcasting years, you've been on that many radio stations up and down the UK, not just in Scotland, but in England. You know, you've been on that many radio stations, and you know, you always get. I mean, you get people that you know don't agree with you, but that's what I like about you. You might be controversial, but you say it how it is. You know, you're not bothered about what people think.
No,
you say it how it is.
No, we say it how it is. And all this woke stuff, while it's a bit of a pain in the backside, you know, we'll find a way round that. You know, that will eventually die off because it's driven politically.
I'm hoping because, you know, this woke thing, as you describe it, it's affecting normal conversation. It's affecting people having nice conversations because, you know, you can't have a proper conversation with this woke society. And I'm hoping, like you said, that it does kind of die off soon because it's ruining conversations. I mean, for some people, you don't say things. It's getting to the stage where, you know, you're worried about saying this, you're worried about saying that because of what people think. But that's where I respect you, because you don't care what people think. You say it how it is, and you say what you feel.
Absolutely.
You don't hold back, and you know, that's what I respect about you.
Absolutely. And I always remember when I came to Yorkshire, you know, I said, you said, all the Barnsley folk are listening. I said, are they upset? They went, no, not upset. They're loving it.
I remember, do you remember what you used to say? I mean, I'll not say it on air because I'm not sure I can, but what you used to say about Barnsley women, those.
Yeah. Yeah, the drop bottoms. And they loved all that.
It's just fantastic. It's pure entertainment. And I know, you know, when you were at, I'm not sure I could say it, radio station, but you said it so well. So when you were on LMFM.
LMFM, yeah, you can.
People tuned in because they liked you. And you could be controversial at times, and it's entertainment. That's why I think people did tune in. And you'd tell people exactly what you thought about them, which not many people do in this society these days. And I think, you know, that's something that I respect.
No, you see, not doing that is false. I mean, when somebody was talking rubbish in Yorkshire, we used to tell them, and we told them straight.
Well, exactly. I mean, it's not just Yorkshire, though, is it? I mean, it's up and down country.
Well, it's up and down country, but I think... Absolutely.
Belfast, Dublin.
But there was something funny to me and to everyone about a Yorkshireman coming on and saying, right, I'll tell thee exactly how it is, and you listen to me, Scotchman, and I'll teach you a thing or two. So then they come on with all this and say, right, I'll tell thee, I've never heard so much nonsense in all my life. And they would go, what do you mean by that?
Yeah. I mean, I remember, I think it was 98, 99, I got on phone to you when you were on LMFM, and I used to work at a certain restaurant chain, and they were all on night shift and they were listening. And I think at the time, we had a little kind of argument, you know, we were talking and we were.
Hey, hang on two seconds. I'll have to say goodnight to me TikTokers. It's the phone right, in, okay. Glenn. Yes, there's another Sheffield lad on. TikTokers, thank you very much for watching tonight. Stay fabulous and we'll catch up soon. Dinky doo. So there we go. Right, I'm just saying goodnight to me TikTokers.
Yeah, I mean, I think I rung you. I must have rung you about 10 times since you were on LMFM, and it was just once when I rang you, and we had a little argument, and it was refreshing to hear someone say what they actually think and what they actually think about things, and, you know, be upfront. And so, you know, as much as that conversation, it won't be best with you because we've had a lot more. You're not going to remember them all. But it made my friends that were working on night shift, they just laughed and they were...
Yeah, but I remember
you. Know, time and it was fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah, well, it got people through the nights and getting stuck into the taxi drivers and all that stuff, you know.
Well, I mean, when you were at LMFM, there were people that were on night shift. They'd have radio on your station. I mean, your show is what they were listening to through night. Because I think you were on from 10 p.m. till midnight. Or
10 p.m. till 1 in the morning.
Pardon?
10 p.m. to 1 in the morning.
Oh, 10 p.m. So it was 3 hours. Yeah.
Yep. And I can remember driving at 2 o'clock in the morning, and we had to sort out a technical problem and with a news jingle. And I remember leaving, it was Christmas, and I was going to Scotland to see my mother. And I left.
That long drive back up to Scotland.
Well, I left at 2 in the morning. I pulled into Leby over near Halifax to hear the 3 o'clock news coming in all right. Otherwise, I'd have had to drive back and sort it. And then I went off and I got up to the Lake District, went in to fill up with some fuel because I was very low on fuel. And suddenly they had a power cut and all the pumps went off.
God.
So I was.
I hope you got enough fuel in that car.
No. So I had to sit in the fuel station in the middle of the Lake District till about 5 in the morning.
So that weren't a good journey for you then, were it?
Christmas Day, so hardly anybody was available.
Oh God! And I just wanted before I go because I know you were finishing at 11. I'm sorry to keep you, but I kind of agree with the last caller that you had that. I mean, black pudding, I'm not sure if it deserved its place on a full English. I mean, my dad loves black pudding, but I've never kind of been a fan. But I like everything else.
It goes well in Barnsley, does the black pudding.
There's a lot of places in Barnsley that do black pudding.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, every single restaurant in town a full English comes with black pudding.
And I'll tell you what I love about Yorkshire is the folk don't put up with any nonsense when it comes to food. You know, even if it's the wildest chippy, you know, they'll say, "Can you change them chips, love? They're a bit soggy."
Oh, they just stuff it in. They do.
You know, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
And of course, being a foodie, I loved it.
Yeah, I do love a good full English, though. I really do.
You can't beat it.
The English you're known for, isn't it? A full English, but. I was going to ask you something else before, if that's all right, Scotty. I was thinking about visiting Scotland fairly soon because I've never been before. Where do you recommend is the best place that I'd go for my first visit?
Oh, you've got me there, lad, because it's such an amazing place. You could be going anywhere, you know what I mean? Do you want to see the West Coast, the islands? Do you want to see Edinburgh? Do you want to see Glasgow?
Somewhere rural, because I've heard that Scotland's got a lovely rural landscape.
Falling down with rural landscapes, lad.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Listen, we'll catch up. We'll have a think about that, and we'll catch up with thee.
Yeah, well, it's been really good to talk to you for the first time in about 20 years.
And you, lad. Don't leave it so long next time.
Yeah, I've really enjoyed it, Scotty, and you take care, mate.
You look after yourself. And I'll see thee.
Take care, pal.
See thee
later, mate.
See thee, la.
Bye,
la. Ta-da, la. What a top man. There it goes. Now, lovely comments here, guys. Hi, Scotty McCleary. Much love from my house. You take care, Scotty, says Angel. Sorry, a bit late to the show tonight. All the best, mate, says Kevin. Brilliant, loving the phone-in. Way to go, Scotty. The internet, before we knew it, was mostly bulletin board systems, BBS, yeah. Hello from Bridlington. Great to hear from you. Alan, we love Brid, as you know. Bye, Scotty. Dinky-doo. Thanks, Tom. Angel says, Scotty, you look tired tonight. I hope you sleep well. Take care. What happened was I was very, very late last night doing sorting this out, and then I was up at 5 this morning, Angel, and I'm up at 5 tomorrow morning. So I suppose I'd better think about pushing off. Can I ring you, Scotty? Glenn, we'll catch up soon. I'm just going. Visit Greenock, says Dixon. How amazing is that? Guys, tonight has been an absolute treat. This is wonderful. This is growing. It's the way to go. If we can get all the technical stuff sorted, we are in business. Thank you very much to everybody on YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, TikTok. This is Scotty McCLUE saying dinky-doo to every one of you. And ta-da, lads! Make sure you tell everyone about this. Oh!